A number of years ago, I was doing a study on behalf of three universities wherein I had been asked to research what programming courses were being taught at those universities in comparison to what programming languages students were really needing to learn in order to get jobs when they actually rejoined the workforce. My research at that time led me to the discovery that the technical colleges were doing a much better job of staying current and relevant course-wise than the universities were doing. In those days, it took quite a bit more time to build curriculums for students than it does today, and taking detailed courses online was practically an impossibility. It had to be done in classroom sessions. So once a professor had built a working curriculum for his or her students, he or she tended to use it for many years almost without change. I particularly remember while interviewing one aged professor at one of the universities I was working at, saying to me after I'd confronted him about the fact that he was still offering a course on a 3GL programming language, COBOL, that nobody was hiring for any longer, the world having moved forward to more technically current 4GL and above languages such as C, C+, C#, Forte, SQL, and others. He said to me that he was teaching students how to learn, not how to get jobs using a specific language, so the language being taught in the class was irrelevant. This sentence stayed with me throughout that day, and in an eerie coincidence later that same afternoon, I happened to take a taxi ride with a driver who, as it turns out, had taken 4 years of university classes in the field of IT and programming, and this was one of the teachers that he had taken a course from. I asked him why he was driving a taxi, and he told me, almost crying at the memory of it, that to try to make a better life for his family, he had a wife and 2 small children, he had borrowed massively and spent everything he had to get his IT-based degree from the university in the hopes of making a greater income once he had his IT degree. After getting it, he found he could not find a job with his degree because what he had spent his money learning were programming languages that were basically obsolete. Companies were no longer hiring for those languages. They were, in fact, laying people off who had the same skills he had just learned, and the companies were replacing existing staff with more technically current resources so they could build systems that were more current, scalable, efficient, flexible, and ultimately more profitable. I have been in the IT consulting profession for over 30 years, and the reality is that we as consultants have almost always been brought into systems delivery situations because we were more technically current and knowledgeable than the internal staff corporations had on board. Rather than spending the money on their own internal staff to bring them to technical currency, I have often seen where they would hire consultants to build the new systems required because they were in a hurry to regain business competitiveness. And their existing staff were left to maintain the old systems while the new were being built. Once the new systems were built to replace the old, the consultants used left because they were too expensive to keep around longer, and the existing staff were let go and new, more technically current staff were brought in to replace them. This pattern in the IT world repeats itself over and over again, even today. Not everywhere, granted, but it shows up enough times so that you can see this as a real pattern within corporations. In fact, knowing this pattern exists is something that professional consultants use as part of their sales pitches with corporations in order to get consulting and IT delivery projects. Are your sales slowing down? Our new systems can help you regain competitiveness in the marketplace, is a quote often heard. So the bottom line about the IT consulting profession and about IT in general as it relates to IT staff within corporations is that my experience tells me that nowhere within this profession is there any real career security. Corporate systems have a lifespan and they get rotated out just as the IT staff supporting them do, unless they are internal superstars, and then the consultants come in to build the new solutions. My bottom line to this lecture to this point is that to keep getting paid, you absolutely have to remain technically current as an IT professional, and it is on you to see that you keep getting the training and experience in current systems languages, infrastructure technologies, development environments, SDKs, etc., and related systems implementation and deployment methodologies. The next part of this video is that once you have learned the languages through your courses, what do you do with them? How do you use your new skills to earn money? Well, you can look for a job and get on the employee wagon at that point with a company, and you can ride the job for as long as you are able to remain technically current or perceived to be technically current by that corporation's management and human resource teams. Your second option is to learn the art of professional consulting so you can use the skills and knowledge you have gained to sell and land very profitable consulting engagements. Note that you can make a lot more money as a professional consultant if you stay busy at it, and technology is changing so rapidly out there that there is plenty of work to be had if you are technically current. You just need to know how to get the work and how to protect yourself financially while negotiating the terms of your employment contracts. This is one of the primary reasons I've started building my professional consulting series of courses. Once you have learned the programming languages you need to learn, you will be ready to take my courses to learn how to find projects, sell yourself on projects, and then get paid well for the engagements that you secure. So I invite you to take my professional consulting course series as well as the programming one you are currently taking through other instructors. You will very likely be needing both types of knowledge to succeed in your upcoming professional careers. I will regularly be updating my content to give you even more knowledge, and when you've signed up for my courses, you can connect with me if you have questions, making me an additional prepaid resource, in effect, to your new consulting business. I look forward to seeing you on the inside. This is the end of this video. Bye for now.